Welcome friends to CNS Viewpoint. Today, just like every day at 5 p.m., we are connecting again with our perspectives and viewpoints on something which interesting we have read recently. So today we are going to talk about a very important study published in the Indian Journal of Tuberculosis. I read it on Science Direct, and that was about why the joint monitoring missions of World Health Organization to different high burden TB countries must prioritize tobacco control. And it looked into if countries are prioritizing, looking at tobacco use and tobacco control, when they look at tuberculosis. And why is that? It is because tobacco is one of the important second biggest risk factor for tuberculosis. Not just, it influences latent tuberculosis, which means not the disease, just the infection sitting in our lungs or body, converting into active TB disease. So latent to active TB disease, higher risk for those who use tobacco, the higher risk of getting tuberculosis disease itself, higher risk of getting latent TB, higher risk of delayed diagnosis. And even if the person gets diagnosed, higher risk of failure of tuberculosis treatment for those who use tobacco. And more concerning and alarming is higher death rates for those who use tobacco and and get infected with tuberculosis. This is a very, very alarming. And this study was done by Dr. Tara Singh Baum, who is the regional director for Asia Pacific of the International Union Against Tuberculosis and Lung Disease, and the union. And he was joined by several other noted public health experts and scientists from around the world, several government officials and public health officials from government of Indonesia, from Indonesia country, as well as public health leaders like Dr. Gan Kwan, who is of the director of tobacco control for the union, Paula Fujiwara, who was a very senior expert with the International Union Against Tuberculosis and Lung Disease, the union, for a very long period, and currently is a senior consultant. Several other experts. And this is an important thing, because important association between tuberculosis and tobacco use. And this is largely because the countries which have the highest burden of tuberculosis are also dealing with very high levels of tobacco use, if you look at low and middle income countries. So for instance, India has a very high alarming burden of tobacco use. A range of tobacco products are being sold here in the country and used. And of course, tobacco kills over 1 million people in India alone every year. And if you look at tuberculosis, India is has the largest burden of tuberculosis in the whole world. Year after year, if you look at data, every year you will find that India has the highest burden of tuberculosis and very alarming number of missed TB cases as well. And other risk factors. So for example, the biggest risk factor is undernutrition. And we all know that India is home to highest levels of malnutrition in the world, if you look at population wise, and including malnourished children. Then the other risk factors, the top five include, apart from tobacco use and malnutrition, they include alcohol use, which is high in India again, which includes HIV. We have the third highest number of people living with HIV in the country, and diabetes. And as you might have or be already aware of, we have a very alarming burden, crippling burden of people who have diabetes. So, and no wonder all these epidemics, these are like epidemics in their own right. Imagine 1 million+ people dying of tobacco. Imagine about 500,000 dying of tuberculosis, about you know, this is just this crazy. If you look at just the numbers in India alone, if you look at diabetes, like, you know, the number of people with diabetes is many, many tens of millions. I think if I remember correctly, it's more than 50 million, but I could be either underestimating or could be wrong here. So I think it is extremely important paper that if we are to end tuberculosis in India and other countries in the world from the planet, and all our governments have promised to end tuberculosis by 2030, then we have to prioritize all the risk factors, including tobacco control. We can't ignore it anymore, and they must get full attention so that they are effectively addressed. And this is also, I wanted to add here quickly before we go look at more details of the what are part of this paper, is that you know, out of all the risk factors for tuberculosis, if you look closely, I think tobacco and alcohol, these two are so doable. I mean, you know, these are, people say these are man-made disasters, man-made epidemics, tobacco use and alcohol use, or human-made or human-made disasters or pandemics. But actually, these are, if you look at closely, you know, these are industry-propelled epidemics that are killing millions of people worldwide, not just in India alone. And corporations that mint huge profits because of tobacco use and alcohol use, they go scot-free. They're knowingly selling a product that kills or that causes devastation in our families and societies and communities and individually to all of us. But, you know, if we get impacted because of range of reasons, for example, economic loss of tobacco use is $1.4 trillion every year to the global economy. Likewise, tobacco also has a devastating impact on our environment. Cigarette butts, for instance, are the biggest man-made pollutant of our oceans. Can you imagine that? Apart from other environmental devastation tobacco causes. So if you look at all the harms, hazards, there's not a single reason which you can come up to justify high levels of tobacco use and poor implementation or weaker implementation or of tobacco control policies, evidence-based policies, which the World Health Organization and several other health experts have proved that they work. So this is extremely concerning, you know, like, we need to boost tobacco control, end tobacco and end of alcohol and other life-threatening disease-causing lifestyle habits has to happen. Like, for instance, big food, they all need to be held accountable, and industries need to be held accountable so they are made to pay for the disaster they have unleashed over the human race just for minting more and more profits. And it's government's responsibility, because ultimately it's government which are going to regulate and hold these industries liable legally and financially. Was a major risk factor for tuberculosis in several countries in Asia. For instance, India, Nepal, Indonesia, Myanmar, Philippines. It was one of the leading causes for people who get TB disease. This is alarming. And again, please remember, these are also the very countries where TB and tobacco use is very, very high. So this is important. And if you look at World Health Organization's data, WHO data, which is a compilation of government's data from different countries in the world of tuberculosis, in 2018, there were over 860,000 or 8.6 lakhs people who got TB disease, at least because of tobacco use. 860,000, almost a million people getting TB disease, which is a preventable illness, which is a diagnosable, curable illness, getting TB disease just because of tuberculosis. This is tobacco use. And this is so very preventable. If we are to end TB, we cannot ignore the big tobacco. If you look at other preventive risk factors, probably this is, again I'm repeating, this is doable, and this will generate more revenues if governments hold tobacco and alcohol corporations to account and make them pay for the disaster they have caused year after year. Likewise, the WHO data shows that about 20% of TB infection will be prevented. 20%, one in five, one in every five, if tobacco was not there on our planet. Imagine, one in five, 20% reduction in tuberculosis is possible just by ending tobacco. And this is very important because, friends, at least since the last 22, 23 years, since 1997, I've been trying to follow tuberculosis program and do my little two bits. I don't think we ever reported such a huge decline in the number of new cases, like 20% decline in the TB infection. The decline, if at all, has been very, very small. Is it the TB rates, if at all they have come down, they have come down at a very small pace. We need a much sharper decline in tuberculosis if we are to end TB by 2025 in India, as promised by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and or 2030, as promised by all the governments in the world, if you look at the Sustainable Development Goals commitments. So this is important. In India, for example, you know, the same paper says that more than 50% of TB deaths were because of tobacco use. 50% of TB deaths in India, as per a study, were because of tobacco use. Similarly, in South Korea, they found that 40% of tobacco users were at higher risk of getting infected with tuberculosis, and 55%, imagine, 55% higher risk of dying of tuberculosis. So people who use tobacco, please quit. That is the best thing, one of the best things you can do to for your health and for your well-being and for your loved ones. There is the only one person, only one entity benefits from tobacco use, and that is the tobacco corporation. Everyone is a loser, including the government, because if you look at the loss, the economic loss, the environmental loss, the public health disaster which tobacco has caused year after year, you will realize that it's governance failure to let this kind of a disaster, a public health emergency, and which is also harming the efforts of the government towards climate, addressing climate challenge, or towards addressing economic economy challenge, for example. So in these times of the pandemic, and even otherwise, there are communities which have been dealing with pandemic after the pandemic. So this is high time that experts who are monitoring, or who go on monitoring missions to evaluate if we are on track to end tuberculosis in a particular area, country or region or globally, they must sincerely assess progress on eliminating or addressing all the risk factors. There is zero excuse for inaction. There is zero excuse for any kind of laxity anymore. The goals and the promises and the targets which have been set by the governments across the world as part of the Sustainable Development Goals and several other forums, we will not be able to meet. Rather, we will fail bitterly if you look at the kind of promises they have made, which is really important. Each of those promises, we don't have to wait till 2030. We should deliver it now, because that they are human rights imperative. But given the kind of a situation we are in, we should at least do all what is doable, whatever is feasible, practical, possible in current times. We must do. There is zero excuse for delaying strictest possible enforcement of evidence-based tobacco control policies. And of course, making solid progress in the upcoming intergovernmental meeting in implementing Global Tobacco Treaty. Let's hope governments resolve to hold tobacco corporations liable legally and financially for the harms they have caused, not just for tuberculosis, but also to our health, economy, our planet. So thanks again to Dr. Tara Singh Baum and several other public health experts who have put up this strong evidence, another strong evidence, and let's hope that the TB monitoring missions will not ignore this the key messages enshrined in this study. So we'll be back again, friends, tomorrow at 5 p.m. just like every day, with our thoughts and perspectives and viewpoints on something that made us think. So see you all tomorrow 5 p.m. again India time. Bye bye.